Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. Welcome back to Black Rose TV NG. I am Rogaya Muhammad Salisu. If this is your first time on this channel, it's a pleasure having you. Do smash that subscribe button and ring the notification bell beside it to get notified when a new video is being uploaded. Today I'll be talking about beautiful ways in which Allah Azza wa Jal answers our prayers. Dua is the most integral asset of a believer, yet it is one of the misjudged demonstrations of worship. In some cases, we become edgy for an answer and can't perceive how and when an appropriate response will come from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah Azza wa Jal answers our prayers in three different ways. What we should have in mind as believers is that Allah always wants what is best for us. He, in His infinite mercy, will grant us what is better and what is even best for us. The first answer to our dua is yes. You ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for something and He grants you immediately, instantly, without any obstacle or anything. We all want this kind of reply. And alhamdulillah, that is a blessing that we should acknowledge and be grateful for. We have seen it happen in our lives countless times. Whenever I see something happen in my life, knowing that it was something I prayed for, something I asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant me, I couldn't be more grateful. It could be a major thing or a minor thing in our life. We should be grateful for all that Allah has blessed with us. Secondly, yes, but not now. You ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but He delays the answer. Do not despair. All you need to do is be patient. Allah loves it when we ask Him for something. Allah loves us that He does this so we could be closer to Him. He loves it when we call on to Him. Sometimes He delays the reply so we can keep calling on to Him and a reward in the process. Sometimes we are desperate for something to happen when we pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but when He delays it for us, it is because the delay at that moment is the best thing for us. This is where we tend to make mistakes by concluding that Allah did not answer our prayer or He did not answer our dua. It is just that our timing isn't right. I could remember a time I was anticipating for a paycheck. It got delayed and I was worried because I thought I needed it then. I received it later on at a time that I needed it the most. Allah always plans everything in our favor. We plan, He plans, but His plans are the best. So whenever we make dua and yet to see the result, never lose hope. It is always in your favor. It will come out at a time that you need it the most. Thirdly, I have something better for you. Allah withholds from giving you what you ask for. This is usually when something is bad for you and you don't know. From the wisdom of Allah, He won't give you what you asked for. Instead, He will change or replace it with something even better. Indeed, there's wisdom behind this decision. It often takes time before we actually realize that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saves us from something terrible. It is a blessing in disguise. Know that no dua goes unanswered. Once in a while, we make dua for things that we believe are good for us, but eventually, it is harmful for us. Allah stops that by changing it with something better for us. Thereby, whenever we make dua, we should always ask Allah to guide us and grant us what is best for us, so that whatever point it comes to us, or whatever structure we acknowledge and understand, it's beneficial to us. Allah has made us from the best of people. We shouldn't give chance to shaitan to make us develop negative thoughts that we are not good enough, or we question ourselves why our dua has not been answered. Allah Azza wa Jal always answers our duas in amazing ways because He says, "Call upon me, I will answer." Simply see what's going on in your life, how Allah sees you through your struggles. You will realize that Allah Azza wa Jal is constantly there for you. Do not quit making dua, for He is all-giving and never gets tired of granting and blessing you. I pray Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grants us all forms of goodness in this life and the hereafter. Show some love by subscribing if you have not. Be a part of the family. Like, comment, keep sharing this video. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.